Welcome viewers, myself Chethan, Assistant Professor, Department of Mechanical Engineering, ATME College of Engineering, Mysuru. Today I am going to give the demonstration on determination of angle using sine bar. So if any given component has an angle, we can determine by using sine bar. The procedure for doing this will be explained over here. So the concept of sine bar is that in trigonometric function, sine means opposite side by hypotenuse. So here this is the sine bar, and if we know the opposite height and the length of the sine bar, we can determine the angle. Suppose this is the component, and we can see that there is an angle, tapered angle in this component, and we have to determine this height. In order to determine the angle, this is the sine bar with the length L, and if we can make this component parallel to the horizontal plane, as if here, where the surface has been made horizontal to the plane, and this can be made by building the height which has been built by slip gauges. So by building the height of the slip gauge, we can determine the opposite side, as well as we know the length of the sine bar as L, we can determine the angle of the given component. Let us move on to the demonstration of the component. Now let us go on to the demonstration of sine bar. This equipment is called as sine bar, and this is the component whose angle has to be measured. You can see that a taper is there in this component, and we have to measure the angle of this component. So in order to measure the angle of this component, we have to place the component on the sine bar, and this is called as the comparator. The least count of this comparator is 1 micron, which you can see over here. And the number of divisions on this indicator, dial indicator, is 200 divisions. So you can see here 0 to 100 and again 100 to 0. So total number of divisions will be 200 divisions. So in order to measure the angle of the given component, first of all we have to make a marking of for 20 mm. Approximate, we can make a marking of 20 mm as shown here. Later we can approximately take a slip gauge height of 10 mm and place it one side in order to make the surface parallel. So by building this height, the angle has been reduced and it has been tilted towards the horizontal plane. Now place the dial indicator on the line, the reference line that has been marked on the component. This is the reference line, and the dial indicator has to placed on the reference line. So here we can see that the pressure built on the plunger and now we have to set for zero and continue rotating. So one round rotation is completed. Second round is completed. Third rotation is completed. And we can see that it has reached the fourth rotation by traveling by 20 mm. So now we can do the calculations and know the height, that extra that has to be built in order to make the component parallel to the horizontal. Let us move on to the calculations. The approximate height calculation is given by the formula deflection, which was observed in the dial indicator, into the length of the sine bar by the measured length, that is the distance that has been traversed on the component, which is 20 mm. So as we have seen in the dial indicator, the dial indicator rotated for 4 rotations, and the one rotation is equal to 200 divisions plus 6 divisions. So totally 200 into 4 rotations, which turned out to be 800, plus 6 divisions. Totally 806 divisions was observed while traveling the component by the dial indicator. And 0.001 is the least count of the dial indicator, as we have seen in the dial indicator. 200 is the length of the sine bar, and 20 mm is the length traversed on the component in order to obtain 806 rotations, 806 divisions. The total value that is obtained is 8.06 mm, and this height is the approximate height that we have to build in order to make the component parallel to the horizontal surface. So earlier we have seen that approximately we took 10 mm slip gauge, and this 8.06 mm has to be built. The total height is approximately 18.06 mm. So next we will go for the next trial, trial number 2, by adding one more slip gauge of less than 8.06 mm. So that in order to obtain the accuracy, we can go for 2 or 3 trials. And the value obtained right now is the approximate value and not the accurate value. Now we will go on for the second trial demonstration. Now we will go for the trial number 2. Before going to the trial number 2, we know that we had already put 10 mm slip gauge, and we have to build approximately about 8.06 mm. However, I will be taking a slip gauge of less than 8.06, as the value that has been obtained is not an accurate value. So now I will take 7.5 slip gauge, and I will ring with the earlier slip gauge of 10 mm. So ringing is obtained by rotating perpendicularly two slip gauges in order to build a bonding between the slip gauges. The total height that has been built by the slip gauge is 17.5 mm, which is less than 18 mm. And now we will follow the same procedure. Set the plunger on the reference line. Set the dial indicator to 0. Now move the plunger towards the 20 mm reference line. And we can see that the number of rotations is 50 divisions. So it has been traveled from 0 to 50 divisions. Again, we will do the calculations for the required height. So now we are going to the calculations of the second trial, and we can observe that we got 50 deflections in the dial indicator, and the calculation is of the same, will be done with the same formula, 50 into 0.001 into 200 divided by 20, finally it comes to 0.5 mm. So now we have to build 0.5 mm slip gauge height in order to obtain the accurate value. Now we'll go for the trial number 2, trial number 3 demonstration. So the demonstration of the trial 3 is as follows. So earlier we have built two slip gauges, one with 10 mm and second one with 7.5 mm and we want 0.5 mm. So what I'll be doing is, I'll be doing the combination of slip gauge by replacing that 7.5 mm back and I'll be taking the 8 mm slip gauge. And then I will be ringing with the earlier 10 mm to make 18 mm. We will place the slip gauge on the one height and follow the same procedure as that of the previous by placing the plunger on the reference line. And set the dial indicator to 0. Now we will move the dial indicator towards the 20 reference line, 20 mm reference line. And we can see that the deflection is around 1 or 2 divisions. So hence we can say that the height built on the slip gauge is almost the accurate height, which is of 18 mm. Now we will find out the angle of the component, as we have known the height, which is of 18 mm, and the length of the sine bar, which is of 200 mm. So by applying the sine angle trigonometric function, wherein the, if you know the opposite side, which is the height, which is of 18 mm, and the already known value of the sine bar, which is 200 mm, we can find the value of angle value of the given component. We'll move on to the calculations. As we have seen that in the dial indicator, the divisions was 1 or 2 divisions. So hence we can say that the height obtained is the accurate height. So the slip gauge that has been built is 10 plus 8, totally it is 18 mm. So the height, the opposite height is 18 mm and the length of the slip gauge is 200 mm. So finally, in order to obtain the angle of the given component, we have sine theta is equal to h by l, which is 18 by 200. So 18 is the height built by the slip gauge and 200 is the length of the sine bar. So theta is equal to sine bar, sine inverse of 18 by 200, which turns out to be 5 degrees 16 minutes. So hence the component angle, the taper of the given specimen is 5.16 degrees.